Hi, welcome to Market Flow. Today I want to do a analysis on the market. I want to start with QQ, which is the tech sector, and see why it sold off so much. I think it was about 2% down over the day, and that was very painful for some stocks. And after hours, looks like it's a little bit down as well. If you watch my previous videos, you know that this is what I was expecting, and my target price right now is 320. And the reason why is because we completed this double top right here. We have a retracement that completed that. We came back, backtest resistance, it was rejected, and then now it's doing an ABC correction. 1, 2, 3, ABC, all the way over here. 320 should complete this gap. This is where I think bulls should step in and start buying. That's just a level where there's opportunity to buy. Not every red candle, it's a dip. However, if bulls don't get in here, the next level is gonna be 315. And right here, if it gets to 315, that is going to be a warning, a red flag, because then it's not going to be an ABC correction and we're going to go all the way down to 300. If you consolidate right here, it cannot close above 320. It's going to happen, it's going to come down all the way to 300, maybe to these levels right here, 309. And again, if this doesn't hold, the next target is going to be 280. So just so you can keep that in mind. So the spike right here, it has kept this support, and the reason why the spike is keeping this support, I think there's other sectors who have been running and has been helping the market so far, but it's having negative divergence on the RSI. It's a red flag. However, it hasn't broken a level, but as you saw with QQ, once a support is broken, the market can go south pretty fast, because a lot of these traders or institutions use algorithms to trade, and as soon as the market breaks, things go fast pretty quick. So just to be aware of that. So despite not much to worry, there is a few things, but this is a kind of a toppy section. It can continue going higher. One of the sections to look into is XLF. XLF has been pushing the market higher, as you can see. And if I zoom out, so you can see it's looking a little bit extended. It can keep going higher, but again, that's a little bit of a warning for the SPY. If the XLF starts falling hard as well, that's gonna take the market down. And then XLE, the energy sector, is retesting this previous stop. And if oil keeps going up, this is going to be a good trade to the upside and can hold the SPY higher for some time. Again, that's my analysis for the market. Thank you for watching. I'm gonna do a review maybe on Clover. It's holding, at least for today, by the end of the day, it's still holding 820 as support. I can expect it to come down to this trend line right here, like it has done in the past. And if this trend line does not hold, then it's going to come to this section right here. If it comes down to this barn, all of this section right here, this is where institutions were loading. I show you the video about Clover. This is where the institutions were loading their positions right here. So I can see some of them loading more positions right here. This is going to be a really, really tough place for the shorts to go through, but I'm still holding it and I'm planning to buy more. And as you know, if I go into the big picture, the worst case scenario is if it breaks this level right here. I mean, it can come down with the market quite a bit, but if you have high conviction on the stock, long term, I think it's going to be a great value stock, great growth stock. I'm planning to buy more even if it dips as well. Yeah, so that's it. And let's look at some of the stocks that have sold off quite a bit. TTD, as you can see, from lows of $130, they went all the way to 600. Right now, all these stocks that run pretty hot, but they didn't sustain the valuation Like they didn't, you know, their sales, their revenue does not support these evaluations they've been selling off. And if you look at them during the chart, you can tell that as soon as it broke support, they didn't give you enough time to even exit your trade, just sold off. Right now, what are the targets for this stock? It's hard. I mean, some of these ones don't have a pretty good downtrend. They're just selling off hard. I can expect this one to bounce and stay within this range. If this stock is going to continue to sell, it may give you an opportunity to sell right here at this level, or it may not. It did right here. It bounced pretty hard, came up to this level. The safest target is 400, but then again, you never know. Last week I was going to short this one, did a 10% bounce, got rejected, and then it sold off quite a bit. By the time I look at it today, it was already too low. And bad news about this stock is that it broke support. Support was about 102. This will be a place where bulls are gonna step, and the next level will be somewhere around here, about 60. So 80 and 60. Again, not every red candle it's a dip to buy, because if you do that, I mean, look at this. You're just gonna continue buying and average, and then eventually you can run out of money. And don't want to be in this situation. Workhorse, right here, there is no support for this stock, so it can continue to downfall all the way to to $5, $4. Those will be probably good entry levels. F-cell. There's still a little bit of probabilities that it can bounce, but if it doesn't bounce, the next level is 336. Just to be aware where these stocks are heading. Mara has this big head and shoulder right here. So if it breaks this support, which is about 27, or if maybe already broke it, and then they're forming this bounce, dead cat bounce, and the next target is going to be, well, who knows? If this is a head and shoulder, it can sell off quite a bit. Used to be $5. I mean, the difference between this kind and the other ones that I reviewed earlier is that their prices go along with Bitcoin. So as long as Bitcoin keeps being bullish, it can perhaps just trade sideways for a very long time. I don't expect them to break new highs unless Bitcoin goes crazy again. Ron, big sell, 10% as well. And again, it broke this uptrend, came down, back tested it, it got rejected, and then now it's going for $35. A lot of these stocks, I think they're getting pretty close to a complete correction. So I don't think if it's going to come down that much. But yeah, it can come down like 35. 35, there's a little bit of support right here. And then if that doesn't hold, the next support is 23. And I know, again, these prices sound very dramatic, but be aware of where supports are. Whenever there's a support, let's say you don't want to sell your stock for any reason, you can buy puts. And because you have the stock and the puts, well, the puts are going to ensure your price in the long term, few months, whatever timeline you want to buy your puts. Anyway, I don't want to make this video any longer. I review some of the stocks that have sell off quite a bit. Yeah, as you can see, VUCI is going down still, and I have a price target of 14. At least it can continue to go down to all the way to $10 from there. But I have puts on this stock, so I'm pretty happy about that one. Beam is another one that I have puts. I bought him Friday when it came up here to this level right here. I bought him, and I'm surprised they haven't moved that much. But the reason why I bought this one is because there is really no support right here. So once it break this level, which I think it already broke, it closed below any close in the past. The way you can do that is you click here, and then you see that it's making lower lows, lower lows, it may bounce, backtest this high, and then it's going to push down pretty hard. So that's what I see on that one. Again, this is a little bit of a correction for some tech stocks, but it's almost like a bear market for high growth companies who are overvalue, at least in paper. So thank you for watching. Have a great day.